Hello and welcome to another new episode of Learning Simplified. So far in this tutorial of building up a horizontal menu bar, we have done it up to this far. Now the next thing comes first. We will be now adding some hovering color effect to our individual list items. In that particular case, we need to return to our text editor, and here we'll be heading back to the style.css, and here we can see that this is the dot menu holder eval list active class customization. We'll be copying this selector name from here, we'll be testing it, and we will be adding some hover color effect to it. So we are mentioning that the background, so we will be adding this red color right over here, and on the other hand we'll be shifting this color change into something different like this, for say white color. Press Ctrl S, head back to your project, reload, and you can see that this will be the of course result. So this is it up to this far. In the next case, all we wish to have some simple drop down menu effect. It's not actually an effect, we'll see a drop down list item coming out of this menu bar that we have created. So we'll be adding some drop down menu list items into it. The next thing that we need to do, create a sub list item for the main list item that we have created. And in the next step, we need to customize those sublist items into our CSS. So let's head back to our text editor, and here in this index.html, as we had said, that portfolio will be the list item, the targeted list item under which we wish to create a sublist item. Here, right after this A tag, all we are going to do, we need to create another unordered list into this individual main list item of portfolio, and here we will be creating something like this. We have created an item inside this unordered list, and right now we need to create something more for say web. Faculty. So here we'll be putting something like this, graphics and so on. So the number of sublist items, it definitely depends upon your criteria. Press Ctrl S and head back to your project and below. And now we can see that this will be the obvious result. We have created another unordered list inside this portfolio list item that we had created earlier, and now we need to make some customizations here. As we can see that this individual unordered list item, it is practically gaining some parental CSS properties into it, so we need to rectify them. First of all, we will be copying this selector name, and here for say we are mentioning UL list, and this individual sublist item, it practically emerges into the menu list item, but it is outside this individual href anchor tag of this main menu. So we won't be using any kind of A tag or something like this. Instead, we will be now mentioning, always remember that the CSS reads from the right to the left, so it is practically detecting the presence of this unordered list, which is inside this list item of another unordered list inside this class name of menu holder. So right now all we need to do, we need to customize them, and we will be customizing it as list style none, which is being already attributed to it, so we won't be needing to mention it again. But for any cause, for say if we wish to put something else like Georgian or something like this, we need to mention the list style type right over here. So let's have a check on it, reload, and we can see that this will be the result. So this is what we can safely deduce, that actually if we wish to change any kind of list style of the elements into our project, then all we need to do, we need to target the individual unordered list first. Now for the time being, I'm going to turn it off. List style should be none. And on the other hand, let's customize the list element. This is the list element that appears right within this unordered list element, which appears in turn inside the main list item of another unordered list inside this menu holder class name. Now let's turn the float left condition to off. Instead of left, we'll be turning it off here. Float will be none. So if we now reload, we can see that everything comes as a vertical menu bar inside this menu bar. And as we can see, that another extra border has been imposed into our project. So we need to remove this border. Though the border of the main parent list item, it will be still be visible into our project. We need to turn off this border right to none. Reload, and we can see that this border is been now turned off. Now we need to rectify this active href link tags, those we have provided right over here. We will be copying this selector name, and so the text align, it should be left. Important another thing, we may change this text decoration to something else. Instead of this none, we'll be putting here underline. Control S, reload, and we can see that this will be the result. I think there is a little bit trouble with this graphics section. We need to have a check on it. There it goes. Graphics lies outside this active href link, so we need to rectify it. Head back, reload, and we can see that everything comes back into the proper order.